My name is Vincent Mingolone, New York City resident my whole life, born and raised in Manhattan. And I had to do a little 6 months on Rikers Island for disobeying a court order. And I was fortunate enough to be assigned to the Hart Island detail. We'd board the boat, cross over, about 15-minute ride to Hart Island. Then our daily routine is we would just check in, go over the list of what we were going to accomplish those days, because we only buried bodies one day a week, which was Thursdays. The medical examiner's office, their truck would come aboard the boat with us, and the officers did some paperwork, and then we all met at the pit, the burial site, and it was anywhere from, I want to say, the least we did was 11, and the heaviest day I did about 24 burials. What they preferred me doing was I would work on the truck. Basically, I would pass the bodies out. I would take the wax crayon, write the name of the deceased on the side of the box. Then we had a wood router, and you know, I would inscribe the plot that it was actually buried in, whether it was B26-A or whatever the case may be. And then I would pass the body off the truck to three inmates on the bottom. They would take that body and the box, and they would pass it to three inmates that were in the pit. And basically, we would just pass the boxes down, and then they would stack them three high, and we'd continue the process till the truck was empty. Then at that point, the machine would come. It was a backhoe, and it would dump the sand, and we would just rake it in between the boxes, around the sides and everything. We did a full layer of that about maybe a foot above the top box, and then came the actual soil. And same thing, we would rake it in, smooth it all out, and then we would pack everything with ply boards on the sides where we were finished, and we would leave the pit until next week's burial. The detail only consisted of about six of us for the 5 months I was doing it. Towards the end, though, they got about 20 of us, and we were all known as the Hart's Island crew. We all pretty much had the same housing unit, and we were all kept in that six building so that we could be removed daily to go to Hart Island. And at that point, instead of taking the van over every day, it took a big bus, because there was about 18 to 20 of us. And we were told that this is how it was going to be. And I did about maybe 3 weeks of that. Then it was time for me to be released the following week. So they shipped me back to a different building, and finally I went home. So that's how I left off. And I'm going to say that was February 18th was when I got released. The crew that I did work with, they were committed, dedicated. We got the job done. There was no arguing over, you know, this is harder than that, or, you know, you catch the body, you stack them. And we took turns. We did what we had to do, and we got them all done. I must say, you know, we did take pride in what we did, and we knew we were the only ones there for these people. And, you know, it just always intrigued me that there's so many stories. Like, we didn't know this person. We didn't see this person. They're inside of a box. All we know is a name and a date of death. But, you know, we always wondered, did this person serve me coffee? Was this person a janitor in a building? Or, you know, what did this person do in life that they, you know, ultimately wound up here alone? So, you know, we did the best we could with dignity, and, you know, we handled the bodies carefully. You know, it was a labor job, don't get me wrong, but, you know, at the same time, Captain Thompson was on top of us. You know, don't drop them, don't slam them, don't throw them. And, you know, we carried them gently. We did our job, and he always rewarded us. Always said, you know, good job, guys. You know, this was a good day, and we did what we had to do. My concern is, I understand they released a lot of sentenced inmates. So, you know, I don't know if they're going to be able to get the inmate labor that they had before, because even when it was a full house and there was plenty of inmates to do the job, a lot didn't volunteer for that. They thought it was ghoulish. They thought it was, you know, a dirty job. And believe it or not, it was actually one of the lower paying jobs, as opposed to maybe working the car wash or cleaning or any of the other outside clearance jobs. So a lot of people didn't want that job. They didn't want to do that detail. And now I think it's going to be slim pickings, because a lot of inmates for, you know, minor crimes such as I had, they've all been released because of this pandemic.